Hey, this is Matthew.
And this is Andrea.
Welcome back to another Blind Box Monday. Ooh. Yeah, why not? And let's take a trip to Hogwarts this time.
Yeah, I'm gonna stop right here before we get into copyright issues.
Yeah, let's do that. So, today we have from Jakks Pacific the Harry Potter Collectible Wands series.
Okay, well, to be fair, this is the mini wands, as you can see, because there is, I found out, collectible wands of, you know, regular size.
Large proportions.
The large proportions, and then they're, I think it's a blind box, too.
Yeah, I've seen those, actually.
They're kind of crazy. I finally saw them at, I saw them for the first time at Walmart. These I got at Target. Yay, Target.
So we have four boxes. This will be a really quick mini review.
Yeah.
There's 12 wands total in this line.
It's really neat.
And we'll see how good these are, because I'm kind of curious about how these actually look from Jakks. We haven't really ever done a blind box from Jakks before.
No, and I'm curious as well, but I do love that it says, the wand chooses you.
Yeah, that is true. It does.
It does.
And we've chosen these, so we'll see what the box chose for us to choose.
God, I hope we don't get all Voldemort ones.
All Voldemort all the time.
That'd be funny.
All right, so we're going to go switch the overhead camera and get to unboxing. So we'll see you, like, now?
Now?
All right, so here we have our Harry Potter collectible wands. These are 4-inch die-cast wands with stands. And Harry says the wand chooses you. Yes, even you.
But we should look at the back. The back is what wand will choose us.
So we get 12 different wands potentially in this.
Well, you can start with, you know, the boy who whatever, blah-bitty blah, Harry Potter, Minerva McGonagall, Bellatrix Lestrange, and of course, you know, our favorite Severus Snape. You can also get, and this is one of the newer ones, you can get Newt Scamander. I can never say that
Scamander.
Right. Scamander.
Scamander Newt.
Commander Newt. You can get Ron Weasley, Hermione Granger, Dumbledore, and spoiler alert, if you're getting Dumbledore's, you know you're getting the Elder Wand. Because it was.
Yep.
And also, you can get Porpoisetta Goldstein. I do love that. Luna Lovegood. Of course, Lord Voldemort. Or as we like to call him, Lord Noseless. And Draco Malfoy.
Yeah. So we got four of these. I guess let's just get started and start opening them.
Yeah.
See who we got.
It's just a little bit of tape, so it's not the worst.
Ooh,
who's that?
Right. So I didn't realize it came with a little...
That's the stand.
That's the stand. Wow, that's a really nice stand. So who the heck is this? I think this might be Hermione. I think this is Hermione's.
Hermione's. You hear what you're saying. I get it.
That's Hermione Granger's, looks like.
Oh, wow.
Miss Granger.
Wow, so you're apparently a smarty pants.
Yeah, sorry, I want to show who you got while I assemble.
I'm a little scared too, because I think I got Voldemort's.
Oh my, I think you may have gotten Lord Voldemort, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, looks like you got Voldemort.
Oops. I wonder what that means about me.
I don't. I'm just not gonna say anything.
Yeah, I'm gonna try and take this out now. Okay, so one thing I do want to mention about the packaging, it's actually pretty cool because they have two separate pouches. It's one big pouch, but then it has two separate, you know, compartments, so to speak. I think that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
So you go back to Hermione while I
do
that.
Here's what the base looks like when you assemble it. Is kind of cool. So do I just put it in like this is the question, or
do you do it from the...
Do I do it from the bottom?
I want to say it's probably from the bottom.
Seems to fit from the bottom. I mean, that's...
Yeah, bottom.
That's what it's doing. So this is Hermione Granger's. So it is a die cast, so it has a nice weight to it, and the paint job's actually not too terrible either. I'm actually surprised how good the paint job is.
Oh, mine's a little sharp. Trying to get it out of the bag. It's there's a little bit of a sharpness to it.
Yeah. Not really sharp, but it's got
tip. It's got like a little something to it.
So yeah, this is good for vertical display. Unfortunately for this video, had we known this, we probably would have done it differently. But so we're just gonna leave these on the ground for now, like this. And I'll get the stand out of the way. So
this is not... Yeah, this is Lord Voldemort's.
Yeah.
Here's my stand, but whatever. It's all about this. This one's definitely a hefty one. His base, you know, it's got some good weight. Nice feel for it. Yeah, there's... Yeah,
and his is probably a bit heavier.
Yeah, do you want to take a feel?
Yeah, oh, it's definitely heavier. Yeah, and look at that. These are pretty nice, actually.
It's pretty cool. It's just I got Voldemort's wand.
No, I think that's actually kind of cool, my opinion.
Yay! So we got two more lip buds.
Oh, please. We got?
I swear if we get a dupe of either of these, I'm going to be so annoyed.
That will be pretty bad. Considering that there's 12 of them, we got a dupe. I mean, granted, this box doesn't say there's any rarity differences. So for all we know, it's basically just all the same rarity. You know, luck of the draw.
Ooh! So I got Newt Scamanders!
Nice.
Let me take it out so you can look at it better. I'm going to put the stand to the side because you don't need that. But check that out. This is like really simple. It looks almost like a little flashlight at the end.
Yeah.
But it's just, it's cool. I dig it because it's got a little bit of color to it and it's neat.
And I believe I got good old Severus Snape's wand.
So what's that say about us? You got Hermione and Snape. I got Voldemort and Newt.
I'm not gonna touch that one.
If you guys have any comments and any, you know, thoughts, let us know below.
That's wow. Some sure Snapey Snapes.
Yeah, that looks like Snapey Snapes.
Good old Snapey Snape.
Good old Snapey Snape.
So I'm not gonna put together his base because you've already seen it. The bases are all the same. Kind of wish they were different. That would've been nice.
I don't really like the base, to be honest.
I don't either.
I mean, don't get me wrong. It's cool as a base. I like that it's a cool, you know, translucent blue. I love this color of translucent blue, but I just don't like it for the wands.
Yeah, I mean, it'd be cool if it was like an effect coming out of the wand, but yeah. It's just an octopus tentacle wrapping around the base of it.
I kind of feel that it takes away from the wand, and I mean, look, this is Voldemort's thing. How am I gonna get that in?
Well, yeah, I guess
yeah, but this one
way.
I have to do it this way. And
but it's kind of awkward.
Yeah, it's just weird, and I don't like it. But let me see, for Newt, again, yeah, for Newt it fits, but. I feel like it just takes away from the... It distracts. It just distracts from the wand.
Wand battle.
Duel!
Yeah, this is how we duel now.
This is how we duel it.
There's some wizards probably like, what nonsense are they doing? This isn't how you duel.
Well, listen to that sound. So these are selling at... I saw these at Target, and I saw them for about... it was $4.99 or $5.99. And I gotta say... I don't hate it. I don't hate the price point, I mean.
Yeah.
I kind of think since this is die-cast, it's kind of worth it.
Yeah, I think so too. I think die-cast, you know, you're going to probably spend a little bit more on them. So that's not the worst price for die-cast product. No. I mean, we look like a company like Jada Toys. They're all about that die-cast life.
Yeah, right.
So I think $5 a piece, not bad. They're bigger than I thought. I thought they're going to be tiny. They're 4-inch wands, allegedly. They don't look 4 inches to me,
no,
to be honest.
But
maybe with the base, but no, not really.
Yeah, no, but I will say, like I said, the stand kind of ruins it for me. If the stand was better, I would probably be rushing to the store right now and getting a box of these because I do think these are pretty cool. But, you know, the stand is just weird.
Yeah.
But otherwise, I can't hate on these. They're pretty cool.
Yeah, so you can find them at most stores that carry this kind of stuff, like Target.
Target, I know they're supposed to be at Walmart. To be honest, though, I had a hard time finding them.
So if you find them and you like Harry Potter, you should probably get them.
Yeah, I've seen the larger ones more than I've seen the minis. So if you're into the wands, go for the minis. Get the minis, get them before they're gone, and enjoy them.
All right, so that's our look.
I command it.
Yes. So that's our look at the Harry Potter Collectible Wands from Jakks Pacific. $5 at your local big box store, I guess we'll call them.
Yeah, why not?
Yeah, so there you go. Check them out, we got 4. And hopefully you get some different ones. You can let us know what you got if you end up buying any. So we will see you guys next time with some more blind box unboxings and who knows what else, because we always got all sorts of mysteries here.
We got all sorts of wacky stuff.
Yep, see you guys next time.
Bye!
Lumos!